Hi, my name is Harish Madhupati. This example is going to seem fairly simple on face value, but it is going to require quite a little bit of effort to get the correct answer. Let's quickly understand the problem. We have data here for football matches from 1930 all the way up till 2014, and we only have four columns. Column B gives us the home team name and the number of goals that they scored. And then column E has the away team name and the number of goals that they scored. Now, if you want to analyze the historical data for the last 74 years, and we want to, let us say, look at the number of goals that France scored in total, as well as a breakup of the goal scored as the home team as well as an away team, it is going to get a little difficult. For example, if you want to look at the goals scored by France as a home team, and I sort column B to show me France, and let us say we only want to look at 2014, it tells us there were seven goals that were scored by France as a home team. And if we cancel this filter, we can then apply the same France filter to column E, and it tells us there were five away goals. But the problem is that the names of the teams are mentioned both in column B and in column E, and we can only apply a filter on one of them, right? And that's the challenge. So let me cancel the filter. Let's load this data in Power BI. So get data, text oblique CSV. Then this is in my downloads folder. Oh, wait a minute. I think it is in a different folder. So let me select that. Okay, all good. And we have World Cup matches. We directly click on Transform Data to go to Power Query Editor. And what I'll do here is to be able to look at the home team goals and the away team goals separately, we will have to make a duplicate query. And on the first one, let's just rename this and call this home goals. And the second one becomes away goals. From the first query, we can remove the last two columns. And then from the away goals table, we'll remove these two. Now, to be able to differentiate which one of these tables is home and which one is away, we will have to create an additional column. So add column, custom column, and we can call this the type of goal. And the first one is going to be home, and we do the same thing on the other query. So custom column, we call this the type of goal. This becomes away. Now, right now we can't append the two queries because the column headings are not matching. So let's just quickly call this the team name, and this becomes the number of goals, and I'll do the same thing here. So the team name, and this becomes the number of goals. Now that we are confident that both the query column headings are matching, we can select home, append queries as new, select both the tables, and then press OK. What this does is it creates a new table for us, where we have both the queries one below the other, and I can apply a filter on this fourth column called type of goal. So if you scroll down, you will notice that once all the home goals are finished, finally we have the away goal. As you can see, I've made a small mistake here, which is that the name was not given properly. So let's just cancel this and make sure we have done this correctly. So we go back to home goals, which is correct, team name and number of goals. But this one, remember, should be the number of goals, and this should be the team name. So even though the columns are not in the same order, like home goals has team name followed by number of goals, and away goals has number of goals followed by team name, the append will still work. So append queries as new, and then we append the two tables. Excellent. And now when we scroll down and we come to 2014, you notice that once the away goals are over, then it shows us all the home goals. We can close and apply. Now the only query that we're interested in is the append query. So to avoid any confusion, I'm going to make sure to select the other two queries and then hide it. And then we can rename this as our final list of goals. The rest is pretty simple. We can make a line chart, keep the number of goals in our values, keep the year in our axis, and finally, keep the team name, or rather the type of goal, in our legend, right? So this gives a comparison. It tells us that if I look at the entire study period, and let me also add the data labels here. So if I look at the entire study period, let's pick 1 year. So in 1998, away goals were 73 and home goals were 98. And if you look at 2014, that was the first time when the away goals were more than the number of home goals. We can create a slicer with our team name, and then whichever team name that we click on, it will give us a comparison of home versus away goals. So for example, if I select France, this gives us an idea of the number of goals scored by France split into away and home. So I hope you like the example. The result is very simple to consume. But I hope you were able to see how, with what seemed on face value a simple data set, we still had to create, first separate the queries and then create a new query with an append to be able to get the result that we want. So, this is a classic problem because whenever you have an attribute where you have two different fields but the items are actually the same thing, you would want to keep them, sort of in different rows, and the only way you can do that is to first split the table and then append the two separate tables that you have. Excellent. I hope you like the example. I'll see you for the next one. Thank you.